My name is Jeanne-Marie Branche, and I'm the founder of the Freedom Dance Project. The Freedom Dance Project is a nonprofit organization that uses dance to create awareness of the issue of child sex trafficking and also bring healing to survivors. Papillon, which means butterfly in French, is my first piece that I created for the Freedom Dance Project. It was performed for the University of Tampa's Evening of Experimental Dance this past November on the Plant Hall veranda. In collaboration with my dancers, I worked with the concept of flow, free and bound movements, and I also wanted to reflect the movement of butterflies since they represent freedom. My goal for the Freedom Dance Project is to continue to make choreographic works locally, nationally, and hopefully globally. I also intend to start working in safe homes and rehabilitation centers to help these survivors. I'm so excited to see where my work is going to take me, the people I'm going to meet, and the lives I'm going to impact with the Freedom Dance Project. I started the Freedom Dance Project actually in conversation with my mom. I was heavily interested and involved with the issue of sex trafficking since my senior year of high school. And then it kind of trickled along throughout college, and for my capstone project for dance, I had to work with a population in a community using brain-compatible dance education and bringing that to the community. So I decided to revisit this, and I did a lot of research on the issue of child sex trafficking locally in the US and also globally, and it is the third biggest criminal activity and organization. It's interesting to see how dance can impact us as human beings through movement, and I did through my research, it was interesting to also see how much healing dance and just movement can bring to people. So I'm interested to start working with those people, those survivors in the safe homes and the rehabilitation centers who have gone through these traumatic experiences, which shouldn't have happened in their lives anyways. And it just breaks my heart to know that children have gone through this, and reflecting on my childhood, that I had a pretty good childhood compared to them, and they're traumatized, they have a lot of baggage they're taking with them and a lot of burdens, and it's one of my goals to bring them healing and bring them back to where they should be mentally and physically, and seeing how dance impacts people just warms my heart and makes me excited, and I love working with kids, so I'm excited to just get them moving, getting to know them, and making an impact in their lives. I have not, unfortunately. It's hard to talk to people who have gone through this traumatic experience and who are survivors. There are survivor stories available online. There are court hearings. So I've read through those, and I've kind of gained some insight about their experiences and how they are healing and still in the process of healing. But I haven't been able to speak directly with someone, but that is definitely a next goal of mine and for the Freedom Dance Project. And hopefully, I have been in contact with a couple safe homes in the Tampa Bay area, so hopefully within the next 6 months or the next year, I will be able to actually be in there, work with survivors one-on-one or in group settings, and just really collaborate, even with the people who do other forms of art therapy or rehabilitation services, just working with them and trying to incorporate the movement and dance styles of the Freedom Dance Project for these survivors. I got a lot of positive feedback after this performance and after this piece that I created. I will say creating it was a bit of a challenge because I didn't want to seem like I was, in other words, making fun of the issue, but I want to, it's my first time working around a social issue that is very serious and should be taken very seriously. So I wanted to just raise awareness through that. The process in which I worked with my dancers, I read them statistics. I showed them survivor story videos. I also showed them like signs of what to look out for if you might think someone is being trafficked right in front of you, or if you see something suspicious and what to do, who to call, who to contact. And we kind of just had conversations, they wrote in their notebooks, just first things that came up in their heads, and then we translated that into their movements, which we pieced together and created this piece for the evening of experimental dance. So that's how I created that. And like I said, we got a lot of positive feedback. I think it was very insightful because a lot of people did not really know about the issue, let alone didn't know how big it is, especially in Tampa. Tampa currently ranks third in the state for highest rates of trafficking. So I think just that statistic alone, as like a local dance performance and event, I think that kind of made people think and made people kind of reflect on what's going on around them, and things are happening under their eyes and they probably don't see it. So I think it was a lot of positive feedback and just really eye-opening to the community that came out to watch the performance.
One, sex trafficking is a $1 billion industry. Two, every 2 minutes a child is being prepared for sexual exploitation. Three, sex and human trafficking is the third largest organized criminal activity. Florida ranks third in the nation for highest trafficking rates. Tampa ranks third in the state for most trafficking cases.
Child sex trafficking is a cycle of abuse, sold over and over, a constant reuse. Underground, preying on the vulnerable, a crime so insufferable. Needed now more than ever, a voice for the voiceless, a safe place to recover. There is light at the end of the tunnel, lives to redeem. Children must be rescued and free to dream.